In this video, I'm going to teach you how to make a complete program that controls your arm, your claw, and your drivetrain. And this is assuming that you have already watched the toggle tutorial, the drivetrain control, and the arm control videos. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to open up the blocks tab. So I go here and I'm going to first open up toggle test. And then I'm going to duplicate the tab and go back to blocks. And now that I've duplicated the tab, I'm also going to open up first global arm control. And again, duplicate the tab and go back to blocks. And I'm going to select first global arcade drive. And I'm going to copy the opmode and call it first global demo program, as this is what's going to keep all the things, and I'm going to open this up. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to start switching tabs around, and I'm going to copy the code from other programs into this program. So the first I'm going to do is I'm going to copy code from the toggle. And how you do copying code is easiest if you just, what you do is you would take some code, take a piece of code, and then you go into functions, and you just drag a function, you put your code in there, and you control C, you go back to the program, and you control V, and then you can drag the code out of the function. And I'm just going to put this before the wait for start. And then, again, you can see now that servo position is a variable. And now I'm going to go back, and I'm going to put the tally op code, the op mode code. So I'm going to put this function, the code from this function, back where it was. And I'm going to drag the loop blocks in here, except for telemetry.update. And again, copy this function and control V. And I'm going to put this down there and delete the function. Okay, now I'm going to put our arm control in. And so I'm going to create a new function and drag the code that I want into the function. Copy the function and paste the function in here, and I'm gonna put this before the wait for start, delete the function, put this code back, bring that function down so I can see it, and then put the arm control. Copy and then paste. Okay, now this looks good, but the last thing that I'm going to do is I'm just going to make sure that I have all my variables that I need in this program. So I'm just going to go to variables. So you can see I have arm position, which I have, I'm using arm position. I have last value of B, power gain, and servo position. So I found that I'm actually, I'm not missing any variables. So this looks good, and I'm just going to save the op mode. Okay, as you can see, I have first global demo program selected. And I'm just going to hit init and play. And there's the robot. Okay, so you can see if I just go in, and again, I'm just using the right stick as we did in the arcade drivetrain. And then if I hit B, what's going to happen is it's actually going to raise off the ground. So I'm going to hit it again, and I have to lift the lift a tiny bit. So I have to use the left joystick and just tap it up a little bit so that it's at that point.
And so you can see I have the block now. I'm just going to show you how high it is, so I'm going to try and deposit it. And so that's the high combustion chamber right there. And as you can see, you can score in the high combustion chamber. Okay, now I've lined it up for the solar panel. I'm just going to hit B and back up and raise the lift. And so now you can see it's grabbed the solar panel. And once you have the solar panel, it's fairly easy to drive. And there you have it. Now, one thing that happens is that you're allowed to have two drivers, but right now this uses one gamepad and is a little harder for to drive for some people. So now I'm going to talk to you about how to make it go on two gamepads.
Now, the first step that we should do in order to split it up into two gamepads is I think that we should give the arm to gamepad 2 and keep the drivetrain to gamepad 1, but then put the arm and claw on gamepad 2. And so the arm is the easiest one. You just change arm position by gamepad 1.leftstickY to gamepad 2.leftstickY. And then for the servo, the claw, what you're going to have to do is anything that involves the toggle. So you can see this here, this if statement here involves the toggle. You change that from gamepad 1.b to gamepad 2.b. And again, here from gamepad 1.b to gamepad 2.b. And that right there is going to actually keep your driving on two controllers, so you can have a little more teamwork and make it a little easier for the person who's driving the drivetrain. Now, one thing that you might have noticed is that the arm was actually starting to move around a lot, and it started to look like it was finicking a bit. And the reason for this is because of the fact that we're adding to the position, but then as the arm gains momentum, it's going to start going further than what we want it to go, and then it's going to have to go back to the position. And that's just a little explainer here. I'm going to show how it works.
First global demo program there, though it's a little unclear just because of the glare. And I have two gamepads registered. So this one here is gamepad 1, and this one here is gamepad 2. And one thing that I realized that I haven't gone over in any videos is how to register these gamepads, because as soon as you unplug them from the Fire tablet, and then when you replug them in, you're going to see there's no gamepads. What you do is you hold the start button and either A or B, depending on if it's 1 or 2. So start A puts user 1, and start B puts user 2 there. And now I'm going to just in it and play. And as you can see, this gamepad 2, it raises the lift, as well as when I hit B on it, it toggles the claw. And then gamepad 1 can control the drivetrain. And this makes it better for gamepad 1, who has to think about where to go, while gamepad 2 can deal with the lift.